Right. Yeah. Let's go right to the boat. That's what all the dogs can go to do.
Thank you. I'm out here.
Yes. Okay, I'll do that.
appointed unto men once to die, and after this coming judgment. But I am in strait betwixt the two, having a desire to depart and be with Christ, for it is very far better. The last enemy that shall be abolished is death. For the living know that they shall die, but the dead know not anything, neither have they any more endurance, for the memory of them is forgotten. The Spirit of Lord Jehovah is upon me, because Jehovah hath anointed me to preach good tidings unto the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of the prison to them that are bound. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and God of all comfort, who comforteth us in all our affliction, that we may be able to comfort them that are in affliction through the comfort wherewith we ourselves are comforted of God. But have not been manifested by the appearing of our Savior Jesus Christ, who abolished death and brought life and immorality to light through the gospel. If a man dies, shall he live again? All the days of my warfare, all the days of my appointed time, would I wait till my release should come? The thief cometh not but that he may steal and kill and to destroy. I came that they may have life and may have it abundantly. This is the covenant that I will make with them after those days, said the Lord. I will put my laws on their hearts, and upon their mind also will I write them. Now he that brought us for this very thing is God, who gave unto us the earth of his Spirit. So teach us to number our days, that we may give us a heart of wisdom. Okay. Thank you. like a shepherd. He will gather the lambs in his arms and carry them in his bosom, and will gently lead those that have been gone.
Thank you. dog. Did God say? I say to Lisa, to the rest of the family, you all know how I felt about Greg and how Greg felt about me. He was my right hand man for so many years. Lord, work for the Lord, and I tell you, put it all in his hands. Because we realize earth has no solace that heaven cannot heal. I'm here to read the Old Testament scripture. We found in Psalm 90 and 5. Verse 1 and 2 said, Lord, Thou hast been our dwelling place in all generations. Before the mountains were brought forth, forever Thou had formed the earth and the world, even from everlasting to everlasting Thou art God. Verse 4, for 1,000 years in Thy sight are but as yesterday when it is past, and as a watch in the night. Verse 12, so teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Verse 14, satisfy us early with thy mercy, that we may rejoice and be glad all our days. Verse 16 and 17, let thy words appear unto thy servant, and thy glory unto thy children. And let the beauty of the Lord our God be upon us, and establish thou the work of thy hand upon us. Yea, the work of our hands establish thou in you. Reading of God's word for the people of God. I thank God for this opportunity. Know that we are here to serve you, whatever you need, by faith, Baptist Church. Thank you so much.
For you this evening to give you the New King James rendering from the book of 2 Corinthians, chapter 5, verses 1 through 10. It talks about the motivation of the future presence of Christ. 2 Corinthians chapter 5, starting at verse 1, it says, for we know that if our earthly house, this temple, is destroyed, we have a building from God, a house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. Verse 2 says, for in this we groan, earnestly desiring to be clothed with our habitation which is from heaven. If indeed, having been clothed, we shall not be found naked. Verse 4 says, for we who are in this tent groan, being burdened, not because we want to be unclothed, but further clothed, that mortality may be swallowed up by life. Verse 5 says, now he who has prepared us for this very thing is God, who also has given us the Spirit, as a capital S, as a guarantee. Therefore, we are always confident, knowing that while we are at home in the body, we are absent from the Lord. Verse 7 says, for we walk by faith and not by sight. We are confident, yes, well pleased, rather to be absent from the body and to be present with the Lord. Verse 9 says, therefore we make it our aim, whether present or absent, to be well-pleasing to him. And finally, verse 10 says, for we all must appear before the judgment seat of Christ, that each one may receive the things done in the body according to what he has done, whether good or bad. God have blessed to the reading of his word.
Amen. Let's pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you, Lord, for another day. And God, we even give you praise in all of this because we know to be absent in the body is to be present with you. We thank you, Lord, because of his lifestyle, because of his love for you, that he's present with you today. Now, Father, we ask in the name of Jesus that, Lord, your grace, your mercy will be extended to the family like never before. God, we pray that you would release a strength on them and in them that, God, that would even surpass their own thinking. I pray, Father, that there will be a revelation of you in all of this that they have never known before. God, we know in these times the heart is heavy, the load is heavy. There are many sad folk in this place today. There are many that's been crying and still crying. But God, we know that you're the same yesterday, today, and forever. You do not change, God. Your love, God, surpasses all of our understanding. And Father, we thank you now that your love for this family, that God, it will be revealed like never before. Just thank you, God, for all things, because even in this, you're still good. Even in this, God, you're still worthy to be praised. Even in this, God, we say hallelujah, because you're still worthy today. You're still worthy, God, because you're still God. And this did not catch you off guard, not catch you by surprise, even though it caught us by surprise. You've been aware of this thing, God, before the foundation of the world. And today, Father, because of your love, your grace, and your mercy, I pray now that God, you would impregnate them for greater grace, a greater mercy, a greater love, that they will be able to bear and get through all of this. We thank you now for the strength that's being released in this family. Such a sad time, but God, because of your scriptures, and those of us that believe the word, and to be absent with you is to be present. To be absent in this body is to be present with you. And we thank you now, knowing God by faith that he's enjoying your presence. Knowing by faith, God, that there's no more sickness. Knowing by faith, God, that there's no more pain. Knowing by faith, God, that there's no more sorrow. Hallelujah. Rest on, brother. Hallelujah, Jesus. Rest in the presence of the Lord. In our name, our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, we thank you for all things. In Jesus' name, amen.
This is what it's about when we are born again believers of Jesus Christ. Even in the midst of sad, emotional times, we yet have to bless the Lord at all times and let his praises and healing be in our mouths. Now say to your family, if you'll praise the Lord, he inhabits the praises of his people, and the strength of God will flood your heart, and he will give you what you need. Amen. At this time, we will have a selection more by Living Waters Ministries, and after that, Marcella Phillips will do our acknowledgments and obituaries. The obituary, and following that, we will have a 2-minute remark by Apostle R.C. Bruins.
How great is our God?
Say with me, how great.
St. Paul Missionary Baptist Church, Tarboro, North Carolina, Reverend George Terry, pastor. Weeping may endure for a night, but joy cometh in the morning. The pastor and St. Paul Missionary Baptist Church family are in prayer with you during your time of bereavement. We pray God's love, peace, and joy will comfort you through these times. Reverend George Terry and the St. Paul Missionary Baptist Church family. With sympathy, many hearts go out to you at this time of loss. Though no one can take away your sorrow, we hope the support and loving concern of others will bring you comfort and strength. Orange County Government. Forever remember, forever love. To the Horne family, hoping each loving memory will soften the grief you feel now, bringing peace and healing day by day. Here at Edgecombe Community College, we too mourn the loss of Mr. Gregory Horne, class of 2022 graduate, 2021 to 2022, Phi Theta Kappa ECC chapter president and great ambassador and cheerleader of the college. We will forever miss him, but are blessed and forever enriched by the time he was with us. Our thoughts and prayers will remain with you and all who will miss him, as we all will here at the college. May God bless and keep you. Sincerely, Grant McLeod, President, Edgecombe Community College. With heartfelt sympathy in your loss, God is my helper. The Lord is the sustainer of my life. Psalm 54 and 4. May the healing gifts of time and the timeless love of God carry you gently through the loss you're feeling now. Reverend Pastor Shirley Neal, the Glorious Tabernacle of Faith Ministries. He is at work in every situation, and he is always right on time. I'm holding you close in prayer, knowing that you know that even in this situation, he's got you. I do too. With deepest sympathy for your loss, we love you. Curtis and Tina Gooding. With sincere sympathy, there are times along life's journey that can test the spirit deeply. Though this is certainly one of those times, may you never stop believing that your faith, your inner strength, and the power of God's love will carry you through. In deepest sympathy, Sheriff Clee Atkinson and staff, Edgecombe County Sheriff's Office. Because God cares and understands and loves you more than you can imagine, I'm asking him to hold on to you extra tight as he helps you through this, praying for you. Don't worry, because I am with you. Don't be afraid, because I am your God. I will make you strong and will help you. I will support you with my right hand that saves you. Isaiah 41 and 10. The ministry partners of End Time Harvest Outreach Ministries send our deepest condolences to the Horne family. Apostolic Pastor Greg was one of a kind. He will be missed, but we know he's with Jesus. The obituary. Homegoing celebration for Apostolic Pastor Gregory Thomas Horne Sr. Sunrise, April 2nd, 1965. Sunset, September 25th, 2022. Gregory Thomas Horne Sr. was born on April 2nd, 1965 in Edgecombe County, North Carolina. On Sunday, September 25th, 2022, God transitioned him peacefully from his earthly home to eternity. Gregory attended Edgecombe County Public Schools, graduating from Southwest Edgecombe High School in 1983. He attended North Carolina Agricultural and Technical State University for a few years. On May 14, 2022, he graduated from Edgecombe Community College with his associate's degree in Applied Science, Human Services Technology, and Criminal Justice Technology. Gregory was employed with Coffee Grow Inc. in Greenville, North Carolina, for several years as a service technician. In February of 2015, Gregory became a detention officer with the Edgecombe County Sheriff's Office. Shortly after that, he was promoted as a detention corporal officer. Gregory was a very humble, dependable, responsible, honest, compassionate, and kind person. He treated everyone with respect, fairness, and dignity. He never complained about anything. Gregory was preceded in death by his father, James Thomas Horne, his mother, Lula Rose Hussey Horne, his brother, Dennis Wayne Hussey, his son, Demetrius Devon Everett, his mother-in-law, Rosa Everett Smith, and several other relatives. Gregory leaves to cherish his memories, his wife, Prophet Evangelist Teresa E. Horne of the Home, one son, Gregory T. Horne Jr. of Lusby, Maryland, one daughter, Minister Alexis Brianna Ballard of Medmond, North Carolina, one brother, Minister Linwood Flowers, wife Anne Renee Flowers of Pine Top, North Carolina, three stepbrothers, Bobby Thompson, wife Gloria Thompson of Hinesville, Georgia, Vincent Barnes of Washington, North Carolina, Victor Barnes, wife Kimberly Barnes of Brookton, North Carolina, one sister, Carolyn Jean Highsmith of Bronx, New York, two stepsisters, Myra Branch, husband Leander Branch, and Cynthia Tucker, both of Brinkley, North Carolina, two aunts, Nancy Freeman of Tarboro, North Carolina, and Lily B. Randolph, husband James Randolph of Speed, North Carolina. His father-in-law, Samuel Lyons of Tarboro, North Carolina, two brothers-in-law, Milton Smith, wife Latasha Smith of Katy, Texas, and Samuel Pitt of Rocky Mount, North Carolina, and two sisters-in-law, Jessica Everett of Indian Head, Maryland, and Demetrius Lyons of Tarboro, North Carolina. One special brother, cousin Camillus Butch Dancy Sr., and two goddaughters, J.L. Liberty Knight and Camden Savannah Knight of Franklin, Tennessee, and one special bonus son, Puncho, of Princeville, North Carolina. Gregory is also survived by a host of other loving family and friends. Acknowledgements. The family of Gregory Thomas Horne Sr. express our deepest and heartfelt gratitude and appreciation for all acts of compassion and kindness shown during this time. A very special thanks to Henry Willoughby Mortuary, Apostle Prophet Ernestine Brinkley, and the Deliverance Tabernacle of Praise International Church Ministries, Apostle Alicia F. Lindsay, and the Ignited Blue Apostolic Church, End Time Harvest Outreach Ministries, Sheriff Cleveland Cleve Atkinson, and the Edgecombe County Sheriff's Office, Dr. Gregory McLeod, and the Edgecombe Community College, all EMS workers, Orange's Coffee Pro, and PAX Catering Service. Thank you.
Solid, firm, stable, unchanging, I look as she read the obituary. It says Gregory was a very humble, dependable, responsible, honest, compassionate, and kind person. Sorry. They coined the phrase even in this. So you look at today, you may look at his wife, you may look at the family, you may even look at him. And you may wonder why we at one moment we may have tears streaming down our eyes. And at the same time lifting our hands up and giving God praise. Because even in this, I've seen him frustrated. I've seen him sad. I've seen him disappointed. I've seen him going through things. But again, I say he was sorry. And they formed the phrase, even this. Oh, how about the old shout? So even in this, we give God praise. Even in this, we give him glory. Even in this, even in this, for us we honor. We got a hallelujah. And we got a thank you, Jesus. Because the God of the Lord is our strength. And we choose to praise him. Even in this.
Remarks by Sheriff Cleveland Atkinson, Edgecombe County Sheriff's Office, and then Tamara A. Frank Corbidin, excuse me if I mispronounce your last name, Phi Theta Kappa Advisor of Edgecombe Community College, the father, and then Dr. Gregory McLeod, President of Edgecombe Community College, and then Minister Alexis Battle. God bless you.
Good evening.
Good evening.
You know, I'm going to ride over here. I'm riding with Corporal Hinton and Officer Brinkley over here. I'm gathering my thoughts. And he knows my name comes on the radio. And I tell you guys something. We all have telephone numbers. We all have addresses. We all have social security numbers. But God called Gregory Horne's name. That is the difference. When your name is called, his name was called, his number was not up. And so when his name was called, he had to go. Teresa, the Horne family, my ECSO family, this is never easy. But Greg exhibited everything that every man and woman in here should exhibit, the fruits of the Spirit. He was gentle. He was faithful. He had self-control. He was good. He was He was patient. He had joy. He was peaceful. And above all, he showed all the love. And I don't know about all you guys that here to my ECSO family. Greg would call me from time to time an invitation. Teresa, he would encourage me as a leader. And you guys got to encourage leadership. Because sometimes leadership can be leadership down. And we get heavy. And Greg had texted me, he had emailed me, he had called me. And the last thing he said to me was this. He sent me something, Luke. And he said, Sheriff, you keep giving and you keep loving. This is one of my employees. And he sent me this and said, give and it will be given to you. Good measure. Press down. Shake it together. Turn it over. We'll be going into your life. But with this measure, it will be measured into you. Let me translate for some of you guys who don't know this. Don't pick on people. Don't jump on other people's family. This is what my employee gave to me as a sheriff. Criticize other people's faults. Don't do that. Unless, of course, you want the same treatment. Don't forget those who are down. The hardness can boomerang back to you. This is what Greg said to me as a sheriff. My employee. Be easy on people. You'll find life just a little bit easy. Give away your life. You'll find that giving back is not merely giving back, but watch this. Giving back with bonus and blessing. giving, not getting. That's what we got to do. That's what Greg Jones told me, Sarah. Keep giving, keep loving. Guess what? Generosity. Begets generosity. Rest in peace, my brother.
Had a benediction, though.
That's all I would get. I always got the sense that we had shared a happy secret, and that he was trying to stop himself from laughing out loud. For those of you who are not aware, Gregory was also a very sharp dresser. He impressed people with both his appearance and his personality. Without even trying, he could easily outclass me in my best efforts. At one induction, he showed up in a suit that was an unusual but beautiful color. Then I looked down and I realized he was wearing dress shoes that were an exact match for that shade. I said, "How in the world did you find shoes that match exactly?" As I was looking at his feet, I realized how shiny his shoes also were. I added, "They are so shiny. They are like mirrors. I can see myself in them." All I got back was his special, shared, sneaky smile. Gregory made a lasting impression on many people at the college. Dr. McLeod, I know, continues to think very highly of him and really appreciates the opportunities he had to talk to him and get to know him better. Ryan Cox, the chair of Gregory's most recent degree program, commented, and I quote, "Though I only had him," meaning in his program, "for a short period of time, I feel lucky that I was able to experience his warmth, kindness, and intelligence. He was a great student and human being," end quote. Gregory supported the scholarship efforts of others and was a lifelong learner himself. He had a natural talent for leading, quietly acting as an excellent role model, respectable, relatable, dependable, and responsible. He spent most of his waking moments interacting with others and serving the community in whatever way he could. In other words, he represents, still, everything a five-minute captain is. I have joked a few times with Teresa about this in the past, but today I want to be sure the family knows that I sincerely mean it when I say that we are so grateful that she was willing to share him with our Phi Theta Kappa family. The sadness in a moment like this is about ourselves and how much we will miss him. If we focus on him, the comfort in a moment like this is the realization that we received a gift in knowing him and in the kindness and inspiration he brought to all of those whose lives he touched. Thank you.
Given all honor and thanks to God for his grace, his mercy, and his love, and for the opportunity to be here with you. Let me begin by offering first my sincerest condolences to the family, church members, colleagues, and friends of Mr. Gregory Horne. For those of you who do not know me, I'm Gregory McLeod, proud president of Edgecombe Community College. And it is my honor to have the opportunity to stand before you on behalf of our faculty, staff, students, and board of trustees led by our chairman, Reverend Jerry Spruill, and for us to host this service here on our campus for the family. When I got the program, I knew tomorrow and I would in trouble because Reverend Atkinson, Sheriff Atkinson.
That's right.
So I'm nervous with all of you. But anyway, thank you for that sermon.
Amen. Amen.
I always enjoy listening to you. Always. As you heard from the reading of the obituary, Mr. Horne attended North Carolina A&T State University. And while I'm sure he had a lot of evil pride, Aggie pride. Are there any Aggies in the house?
Aggie pride?
He also had a lot of evil pride. And I'm not talking about NC Central. He was a proud Edgecombe Community College Eagle, because we are the Eagles here. His pride was clear. He was an outstanding student, consistently getting high grades and earning his place on multiple dean's lists and president's lists. And as you heard from Ms. Tamara Frank Prabati, he was inducted into the Phi Theta Kappa Honor Society in 2018 and served as chapter president last year. And in this past spring semester, when I needed two students to step up and help me host several elected and state-appointed officials for a tour and a meeting right here on this campus, he and then PTK VP Tiffany Wolf, who I believe is in the audience, I saw her in the back there, stepped up to the call representing our college, our student body, and our community oh so well. And this past May, at our graduation on this very stage, Mr. Horne, as you heard from the reading, received not one associate degree, but two associate degrees in applied science, one in human services technology and the other in criminal justice technology. And on top of that, as Ms. Frank Prabati said earlier, he was recognized at our graduation right here on this stage as the college's 2021-2022 nominee to the state for the Governor Robert W. Scott Student Leadership Award. That's a very special award for us, and only one student is recognized each year, and he was our nominee this past May. So I'm honored that Gregory Horne chose to attend our college. I'm honored to have known him and will certainly miss him. And besides, there's not a lot of Gregories out there. Frankly, Gregory Horne represented the best of us. And I hope his commitment to academic excellence, his leadership, and service will forever inspire all of us to be all we can be and to give our very best, as he certainly gave his best here at the college, as a proud ECC Eagle, and in everything else he did. Thank you, family, for sharing him with us, and God bless you.
Thank God for all of those comments. Minister Alexis Donald is coming. At this time, this is the daughter of Apostolic Pastor Gregory Horne and Father Teresa Horne. Come on and clap your hands and wasn't just a little friend.
right time for me to meet Greg. We met. He spoke and introduced himself to me. Of course, I was respectful and introduced myself as well. We talked for a few minutes, and one thing I still remember to this very day that Greg said to me, "I will never try to replace your biological father, but I am here to be a father to you. If I love your mother, I have to love and accept what comes along with her." At that moment, I wasn't trying to hear that. It wasn't nothing personal towards Greg. It was just the fact that it was my mother and I for so long in the home that one day it wouldn't seem normal to know that someone else would be in our household, let alone a male figure. Now that I have met him, he started to come over more frequently. Before he came over one day, he asked my mom, did she or I want anything? Now, you know me, sometimes my shyness or my pride, as my mom would call it, will have me tell people, no, I'm fine, I'm good. But I put this man to the test. I told my mom to tell Greg to go to McDonald's and get my favorite meal, my go-to meal, chicken strip meal with honey mustard sauce and a Sprite drink. And guess what, y'all? He came to that wedding. It was only Papa Dan. I was ready for him to get there.
The Lord of hosts. He is the King of glory.
comfort will be released through yours truly, Holy Spirit and I.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. 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 Don't give up on God, because he won't give up on you. He is able. Oh, yes, he is. All right, saints of the living God, my assignment is to preach this gospel of the kingdom, to release the message of comfort. Hallelujah. Just like these amazing fine officers are here, their assignment, the sheriff, is to maintain the order, to keep us safe, and look out for us. Just like others, your assignment to do what you have to do. Mine is to declare the kingdom of God. Mine is to let you know, even in this type of situation, that there is still hope. As long as you're breathing, there is still hope. Came today in the volume of the book that's written of him to do his will. I honor Apostle Thadford Brinkley Jr. I honor all the other apostles, all the those that are in authority in other ways, evangelists, pastors, and teachers, certainly recognize apostolic pastor, though he's absent from the body and present with the Lord. We knew him in so many different facets of different places that he had to carry those torches and those weights. He was a father, he was a husband, he was working with the Lord because they worked with so many things, but he also was a pastor. He also was a man of God that loved God and that was concerned about souls. And glory to God. And we love him and we do miss him. And we thank God for Prophet Teresa. We thank God for Minister Alexis. We thank God for End Time Outreach Harvest. We thank God for one another. Can you clap your hands for somebody else other than yourself? Amen. We are grateful. A thankful fashion. My spiritual son, Apostolic Pastor Gregory Horne, our spiritual son, also had a friend in my baby brother, my youngest brother David, who loved him so that he would travel in from Virginia to this, though he has a lot of schedules. That's what love do. Love do what love does. Amen. Love do what love does. And I want to admonish you before we actually hit this word, is to just rethink your life. Rethink what's most important. Because a lot of things that we think are important are not even as important. And let's prioritize those things that need to be put in order, so that when that day comes, if that day should come and not by way of the rapture, that it be well with you. We need to live ready. We have to live ready. Words that we can share with one another out of our heart about how people have been a part of our lives, you know, are one thing. But no matter what all of us say about anybody, what is Jesus going to say? What is Jesus going to say in the end? Either well done, thy good and faithful servant, enter into the joy of the Lord, or depart from me, your work of iniquity. And though we love and we share and we do all kinds of accolades for one another, Apostolic Pastor preached his own eulogy with his life. There is nothing anybody can say or do to take away from him what he's already done, or to add to him something that he didn't get to do. Only what every one of us do for Christ that he has assigned to us to do will be counted. Only that will last. Please make sure that you have a right relationship with Jesus Christ. Please make sure that your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Please make sure that you have been redeemed by the blood of Jesus Christ
for there is no other name given among men whereby man can be saved but the name of Jesus. No religion can do it. It has to be a right relationship with Jesus. So live right. Revelation tells us that however we live, that's how we'll die. And how we die is how we will rise. Now let's look at 1 Corinthians, the 15th chapter. Move on into that message of the word. The word of the Lord today is death has no power. Death has no power. 1 Corinthians 15, 55 through 57. O death, where is thy sting? O grave, where is thy victory? The sting of death is sin, and the strength of sin is the law. But thanks be to God. Okay, now, I know some folk in here say they're full of love. But thanks be to God. This is a Holy Ghost filled preacher that went home to be with the Lord. But thanks be to God, which giveth us the victory through Christ Jesus. I went on a journey in the spirit with the Lord in prayer last night, just seeking him for the now word for this. And the Lord began to take me back to Genesis, the second chapter. He began to say, you know when I put Adam in the garden, that Adam walked with me in the cool of the day. Adam had a right relationship with me. But before I put Adam in the garden, I had created somebody else. That somebody else I had created was death. Death was already in the garden before Adam got there. Are you hearing God? But death had no power. Death was present, but it had no power. Hear God today. In everything that lives, death is present, but it has no power until that thing gets away from the source that gives it its power. And so it's like a plant. If you have a plant planted into the soil, that plant can live. But if you take that plant up out the soil and leave it out of the soil, that plant can die because it gets its life from the soil. Well, Adam, he sinned by disobeying God. Therefore, death that was present had a legal right to come alive. It came alive and began to bring torment to the life of Adam. The Lord had promised Adam, he said, listen, that I gave you in the garden, I gave you every tree in the garden that you can eat from. But the tree of knowledge of good and evil, do not eat from it. Because the moment you eat from it, you will surely die. God is a God of his word. God watches over his word to perform it. He's not a man that he should lie. And when Adam ate of that tree, then death came. But God so loved humanity that he gave his only begotten son. He had to come in the form of a man so that he could fulfill what he said. Somebody got to die. But he didn't want Adam. He didn't want us because we were in Adam to be without the ability to get back to Christ, to have a relationship with Christ. And so Jesus came and died and defeated death, hell, and the grave. And then looked at death and said, death, where is your sting? Grave, where is your victory? Death has no power for the believers of Jesus Christ. So what you see right now, this that apostolic pastor has gone through, that others will go through. Some of us by the way of the grave, some by rapture. But death has no power over the believer. The Bible says we just sleep. Hallelujah. He's just sleeping. There's no death because death has lost its sting. Oh, come on, believers of the Holy Ghost. If you in Christ and Christ in you, death has lost its sting. So we know we may sorrow. We don't sorrow like those who have no hope. The reason why we can lift our hands and give God glory, the reason why we can praise and celebrate this man of God, the reason why we can declare the
shall surely die. So God wrapped himself up in flesh and came and dwelt among men. Because he couldn't come down here as spirit. Because he had to kill humanity. Because Adam disobeyed what he said. So instead of killing Adam, he killed himself. He killed himself. Then turned around and raised himself up from the dead. He said, I'm that kind of God. That I'll kill myself and raise myself up from the dead to pay the penalty for your sins and mine. So he can look at death and say, now what you say about this death? He stepped out from that grave, stepped out there and said, okay, look back around. Said, what do you say, grave? Death, when you see. And grave, where is your victory?
And then rose from the dead and said, come and follow.
only truth and living God. Death has no power. It has no power. It was stripped. Jesus has defeated it. Do not be afraid when death comes, unless you're not right with God. Now, if you're not right with God, be more than afraid. But the older saints used to sing a song and say, get right with God and do it now. Come on, let's pray. Father God, in the name of Jesus, while I'm praying, if you don't know Jesus as your Savior and Lord, and you want to receive him into your heart, right where you are, just stand to your feet. Because if you're afraid to own him before man, he'll be afraid to own you before the Father. Hallelujah. Just check your reservations if you're born again. You may go to a hotel and have a reservation and things get all crossed up because you're dealing with humanity. So if you want to check that reservation, make sure you have that. Check your reservation. Make sure your name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Make sure it's well with your soul. We can walk out of here on our way out and somebody could drop dead. We can get in a car accident and somebody could kill somebody. Oh, glory God, anything can happen. You can go to sleep and never wake up on this side. But just make sure it's well with your soul. Father God, in the name of Jesus, Lord, any persons in this place that do not know you as their Savior, Lord, that do not have a right relationship with you, Lord, by your Holy Spirit, convict their hearts. Help them to understand your love for them, that you would kill yourself to keep from killing Adam, because you did not want us to be separated from you throughout all eternity. May they receive you right now in the matchless name of Jesus. May they open their hearts to the power of your presence, Lord, to know that you love them unconditionally, that you would give your life even for them, for all of us, while we were yet your enemy, you died for us. We're so grateful and thankful. Continue to comfort the hearts of this family. Lord, continue to allow the Holy Spirit to massage Prophet Teresa's heart, Minister Alexis and the son Gregory heart, Lord, to fix in them whatever it is they need to be fixed, that they may maintain for you. Continue to help Sheriff Atkinson and this great law enforcement team. Continue to help the college, Lord, for they miss a soldier that's been with them all this time. But may they reap from what he left in the name of Jesus. Strengthen every heart, mind, soul, and body. And cause us to know that whatever we are doing, even in death, when it hits our place, when it comes to our household, if we are not raptured out, it will too die when we die. That only what we do for you is going to be counted and last to be taken into eternity. For when we leave this earth realm, Father, what was done in the earth remains. But only what can be taken to glory is our obedience unto you. Father, we thank you now that the Spirit of God will rest upon everyone and minister to their hearts, even when they need to go to their prospective places. We thank you for truth that makes us free. And we thank you that you are the God, Abba Father, Daddy, who wipes tears from our eyes. Bless their travel, Lord, when they return to different places. Bless as we go to commit the body, Lord, and even in the repacks, continue to strengthen your people. And may we look to you and walk in obedience to your word. In Jesus' name, amen. People of God, if you're not ready, get ready. If you are ready, stay ready, and let us all live ready. At this time, we want to turn things over to the mortuary. We bless the Lord. The interment will be at East Lawn Memorial Cemetery. Amen. And the repast will come back to Edgecombe Community College here. And we release this now into the hands of the
those that have the authority in this. God bless you all. Praying for you. We love you.
I've been getting a message. I ain't had time. All right. Hey. Boy, come on.
Proceeding him in there.
Wayne.
That was another
Dinner Hood. His name was Wayne. He's Evans' brother.
Right. I ain't think that ain't the same Dinner Hood we know.
No.
Oh, okay.
No, he been there.
Huh?
No, he been there. Wayne been there.
Oh, he been there.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, I was thinking that you know the Dinner Hood.
Right.
That's about them, right?
No. Okay. All right. They cousins, though. Yeah. What's up, man?
I'm trying to get your tip up.
Where you put them in the van?
No, the hearse in the back.
No, the flowers. They
yeah, in the van. Yeah. Yeah.
I don't want to stay here.
Hey, come
here. A little flower for you.
Oh, yeah. What is that?
Thank you. Okay.
I'm doing the word again, man. This is my brother. Hey, girl.